tone. It's not a sound per se. It's an e-vowel. It has some message to be delivered to the populace. Where's that teddy bear? You see him over there? You see him? Mm-hmm. You tell him, crank it up, vino, up yours. Talk to him. Bigger than it really is. If you had to sing a whole goddamn aria on E and A vowel, saying. You just go out further. You go. Soft. You could be holding a dagger in your hand and ready to That isn't what they requested.
What did they request?
Wotan's farewell.
You got the wrong voice.
I got the...
I do what I want to do.
Oh, yeah.
I know more about my voice than you do, so shut up and listen.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Same goddamn thing. It's the same thing as... Don't open your mouth.
Oh!
that you go through it. There's a wall there that you built up, you knock it right down. You don't come to a screeching halt and say, You get ready for it before you ever come to it subconsciously, and you go right through the center. It's like diving off a jumping board.
Okay.
You go, boom, and then you're off into the water. This way, you screech to a stop at the end of the diving board, you jump up and down a couple of times, you think, yeah, well, what the hell? Move.
All right.
And don't know. Always get the tape correct.
Okay.
Where are we?
We're starting from De La Terra, right here.
Where does it begin, the whole area?
Oh, you want to start from the beginning again?
Yeah, start from the beginning. That way you'll get the whole thing. What are we going to do?
We're going to do...
Yes?
Anon giunge, Amina's aria from Bellini's La Sonnambula.
I thought it was from La Cucaracha, but if you say it's from someplace or other, okay.
Thank you.
And I said,
thank you.
the walls down with them. There's not an opera house in the world you couldn't fill. You come to this much. You come to this part. See, there's no voice teacher that can destroy you now. Because you look at them and say, I got claws. Sombres, forêts. What did we say about the higher upper part of your tessitura? It's never high. You never call it an E flat or high note. It's all in the same place as whether your instrument is capable at that moment of functioning naturally with freedom and agility. You wear something out, you tear it apart, you beat the hell out of it. It's like a piece of metal you hit with a hammer, it gets brittle after a while. That happens to voices, plus innumerable others. So your E flat is just temporarily misplaced. You have to trust, see? You're learning technically how to release and open your instrument and the articulation process and all that goes together. Then you have to, in the final analysis, trust. Trust, T-R-U-S-T. If you do not trust, that means that you set up a safeguard. That's like putting a Band-Aid on a mosquito bite, which is fine. However, you lick the son of a gun and you trust it's going to heal. Otherwise, you're going to put a mosquito bite and a plaster cast. Every singer does that. It makes a goddamn sure they screw things up. So you trust, you back off, and if you feel that somebody wants to hear you sing, it does wonders for you. You're dying to hear you sing. If you see people around there, like in Harry's place over there, old frump sitting down there, and he didn't give a fick by singing that, and the old lady conversing, Harry's in the kitchen, I'm singing to myself. Anytime you sing to yourself, you wrap yourself up in a cocoon, then you get tight in the drum. So it's like striptease in front of the audience. Take it off. I ain't like it. You have to. That's the trust involved. Okay, if you screw up then, that don't make no matter. Look at this Mexican tenor coming in here. He wasn't that good. Behind, he messes up the first two acts at Romeo before he gets hot. He must have done them gorgeous at one time. What shook him out of shape? You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
So you can't do that. You have to have the ego like Callison.
Right.
Yeah, okay, where is your music book? All it does is strengthen your concept. Nobody, like I said last week, or you said last week, tear down your instrument. Only you can do that. The upper part of your instrument, the upper part of your tessitura, has got the face resonance that you're lacking in the lower part. Okay, you understand that. The only way you can help yourself, the only way you can overcome it, is to blow it out like a bubble, like a baby goes, okay, and sniff. The sniffing opens up the flaps in your face. You get two flaps there. So it's, you go, sniff, you're all set? Or you gotta talk to me, say. Sombre. Don't get subtle with French. Give me meaning master French. Talk to me. In other words, you're only speaking in the lower part of your tessitura, which means you don't have to do anything until you say, come to, in your instrument, G sharp. Then there's a change of resonance. They call registers. It is pure bullshit. So if you think you're going someplace, you're going high, you will change automatically for the worse. Because all of a sudden you go, sombre for me. So it's all spoken in the same place. Talk to me. Talk to that fire out there.
Natural
for
me.
walk. What is it? Articulated process, whereas you do slow with the consonant, you know. Sombre, sombre, forêts. Ready?
Okay.
The consonant has to leave the vowel.
Oh, you know what?
And something else.
No, but this is, but anyway, what the reason I thought of it is that Avi Stugnani changes vowels to make them come
straight. Oh, yeah.
Often says ah instead of a.
Oh, yes.
She was supposed to have a great technique.
Well, her technique was so she always accommodated her instrument.
Uh-huh.
See, and she could have did the same thing by being more explicit of the consonant and vowels.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, her consonant and vowel were there at the same time. They all sing that way. You want your consonant to precede your vowel.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell are you talking about? The consonant releases the vowel. Sombre. It comes automatically instead of me going, sombre. You see, it's too slow.
Right.
Consonant automatically releases the vowel, brings the vowel to life. That's okay.
Thank you.
sounded all right, but it took its toll on his voice.
Mm-hmm.
He squared his instrument.
Mm-hmm.
So you were squaring your instrument by not going do re mi fa. You could be going do re mi fa.
So I should sort of slide up to it? Or?
No, give me another vowel.
Okay.
See, you're taking that one vowel. You're making, you're splitting that four vowel.
Okay.
So it's no big deal.
Okay.
It only goes to an A if I remember.
Right.
Right, on that, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay,
I
make it again.
Very good. The other thing.
You sound great the first part.
But the other thing is my breath. I'm beginning to be convinced that I'm at a disadvantage with my small rib cage and everything like that. I just never seem to have enough breath. My phrasing is terrible because of it.
Once you know something, the breath is automatically given to you. Don't worry about your breath. You always got enough. Even if you're drowning, you have enough. Just go underneath the water, hold your breath a little more, and then you will rise to the surface auto-fucking-matically.
So
don't fight. You will float.
All right.
Talk to me just the way you did. That don't matter.
Yeah.
You're doing fine here. Go ahead, kid.
Just like the Queen of the Nines F, you come to the doodly doodly doodly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. goddamn fence. Hey, I'm tired. I just ran the whole steeplechase. And now I gotta jump this hurdle? That's about it. Sounds like